Objection. According to Section 32, Subclause 1 itself, a statement may be oral and written, but in Employer versus Apollo, it was held that conduct to be relevant as time declaration. The statement must be as to cause of death, circumstance of the transaction resulted in the death. For Kala Narayan Swami versus Employer, the statement made by the deceased to his wife that he was going to the accused to collect money from him, accusing being indebted to the deceased, was held to be admissible under Section 32, Subclause 1. FIR is dying declaration, where an injured person lost the FIR and then died. It was held in K. Ramchandra Reddy versus Public Prosecution to be relevant as dying declaration. Death of a person is must while making the statement. If death is not the result, the statement is inadmissible as dying declaration. But it might be relied on under Section 157 to corroborate his testimony or to contradict him under Section 145. It can be used to corroborate the evidence in court under Section 6 and 8. Cause of death of the deceased must be in question. Expectancy of death is not necessary. Whatever may be in the nature of proceeding, it may be civil or criminal nature, where the death of the person deceased is in question.